wonderful things to say about today's speaker. She's an energetic proponent of ethical culture and a favorite facilitator of workshops and programs. Dr. Anne Clayson also serves the Columbia University Barnard College community as humanist religious life advisor. Now, you all know this, but I just wanted to refresh your memory. She's a graduate of the Humanist Institute, Class X, which means Class 10. She also co-mentored Class XV, which is 15. I'm very good with Roman numerals. And is now co-dean of the Institute. She holds a Doctor of Ministry degree from Hebrew Union College. She represents the American Ethical Union on the Board of Governors of the Religious Coalition for Reproductive Choice and is an active participant in the Empire State Pride in the Pulpit, New Yorkers Against the Death Penalty, the Interfaith Peace Alliance, and Women's International League for Peace and Freedom. She and her son, Andrew Newman, represented the American Ethical Union in the National Service Conference, which has a new name, the National
Ethical
Service. At the December 2009 Parliament of the World's Religions in Melbourne, Australia. She also serves the American Ethical Union as chair of the training committee, which is responsible for recruiting and training ethical culture leaders and celebrants, and is National Leaders Council liaison to the Religious Education Committee, the Youth in Ethical Societies for Teens, and the Future Ethical Societies for College Students. Now, I'll bet any money you didn't know all that.
I forgot some of it.
So here is our very favorite lady, Anne Clayson.
Thank you.
Well, this is cozy, isn't it? I'm delighted that so many of you came out and decided to brave the blizzard that's on its way. But with any luck, you'll get home before it really hits hard and you'll be safe and sound inside. Remembrance Sunday is a tradition that we started when I came here to the New York Society. It was one that we had at the Long Island Society. Now, there we use candles, but I figured that last Sunday we had our candle lighting ceremony for winter festivals, so let's use flowers and not risk burning down the place. So, especially having had our building centennial, we want to take good care of this meeting house. You know, Remembrance Sunday is a time when we remember those people who have died during the year, but we also remember people who have died at any time, who are so very important in our lives. I want to start with reminding us of who among our members died this year. And one member was just a couple of days ago, and that was Roy Neuberger at 107. So, you know, one thing about our members, they do live long, healthy, wonderful, intellectual lives. That's Roy Neuberger. Florence Weinstein, one of our members, died earlier this year at 102. I don't have the ages of all the others, but suffice it to say, those are the two who were 100. Also this year, we lost Cy Schleffer. I think many of us probably did not know him. He had moved away some time ago. Norma Himes, who died of cancer, and we also had a memorial concert for her a couple of weeks ago. Martha Friedlander, Benjamin Bean, and then Bob Kaufman, who was the leader, the interim leader here, died last week, and Judith and Sylvan Wallach were with him. He was in hospice care in Bellevue in the state of Washington. And he and I chatted some in the last days, very anxious to make sure that we bring back our Humanist Awards ceremonies, and he has a couple of people in mind. So I'll be talking with the board about that, because Bob wanted to make sure that that we kept that tradition going. So I had some very lovely conversations with him in the last week of his life. We bring flowers today as reminders of how to live. In their diversity, resilience, and fragility, flowers are symbols of the endurance of the human spirit and the values that supported the highest of human aspirations. We place them in the vase so that we may remember what is important and dedicate our lives to living that in our daily routine. The colors, shapes, and textures remind us of peace and hope, freedom and love, the enduring values of our ethical humanist faith. May their beauty here today be forever in the lives of all people, everywhere, always. So I will be speaking about different virtues, and at the end of each one, I invite you to come forward and select a flower or two or three, there are plenty here, and place them in the vase. And as you do so, if you are comfortable doing so, please share with us something of that particular value, perhaps. We're going to start with peace, that reminds you of someone that you've lost. And feel free to share with us and tell us a story about that person. This is a time when we can either sit in silence and remember, or we can take the opportunity to share with those who are eager to listen. Peace. May there be peace. May there be the peace of the running wave to you, of water flowing, rising, and falling again. May the stream of your life flow unimpeded. May the deep peace of the running wave come to you. May there be peace on this planet forever. A world where we live with one another as sister and brother. May there be peace in every heart and hand, extended in friendship to everyone. May there be peace upon the earth, in every garden and home we enter. May we be the peacemakers, the sowers of harmony, the bearers of beauty. And there is a wireless mic on the table.
I'd like to put these in the vase in memory of two colleagues of mine from the Kinder Transport Association who died this year, Irene Schmid and Laura Gabriel, who knew what it was like not to have peace because they were disrupted, their lives as children were disrupted when they were sent on the Kinder Transport from Germany and Austria to England.
Thank you, Eva.
A dear friend of mine who died this month, who Robert Winterberger, and he was originally family in Vienna but had to get out and went to Paris and subsequently here to the US and lived in New York. And he was the on the foundation committee of the Players Club in New York in Gramercy Park South, the Actors Club, and also he was the treasurer for the Lambs Club, which is the oldest theatrical club in the country. It originally started in England in the late 1800s and then transferred here. And this was a great shock. May he rest in peace.
Thank you, David.
I'd like to remember Shirley Schnitzer in peace, because she helped us found the concerts 10 years ago, and because she did bring harmony to us.
Thank you.
My mother had burnt orange carpet. And I always think of her when I think of people who are gone. I don't know that she ever had much peace, but I wish her peace now.
Next value is hope. But we have only begun to love the earth. We have only begun to imagine the fullness of life. How could we tire of hope? So much is in the bud. How can desire fail? We have only begun to imagine justice and mercy, only begun to envision how it might be to live as siblings with beast and flower, not as oppressors. We have only begun to know the power that is in us if we would join our solitude in the communion of struggle. So much is unfolding that must complete its gesture. So much is in the bud. Hope is the promise that after the sunset will be dawn, and after the snows will be the warmth of spring, and the flowers of the field, the blossoms and the fruit. Our prayers are of hope and faith that good is found in everyone, that life can be good and full and rich with the joys of friendship and family. It is a faith that is being bound to this earth by taking time to see what is before us, our very lives, become a thing of beauty. This world can be a better place by how we choose to live, a better world for all those who are and those yet to be. By walking side by side, we promise to take care of one another and to give each other the strength and courage to meet another day in confidence and in hope.
I'm remembering my father, who had the courage and hope to leave his native country, Hungary, when he was 18 years old and come to a strange country that spoke a different language. Two of his brothers had preceded him. He lost his parents and all of his other siblings. There was 13 children in the Holocaust, and came here and started a wonderful life. It was a loving, giving, generous, cheerful, good father and husband.
While Pat's up there, I'll remind you that Roy Neuberger was a past president of the New York Society for Ethical Culture. His wife, Marie, was head of the Board of Governors of our Ethical Culture School for 13 years. Mm-hmm. So they were very active in the life of the society. Oh.
Thank you, Pat and Chuck.
This is for all the people that have promoted human flourishing on the planet. And you know who they are, and they include many, many, many people.
Thank you, Ken.
I'd like to wish peace to my companion who lived with me for 10 years and had a wonderful life. I wish her peace. She now resides in a home and she has Alzheimer's, and I hope she is still in peace.
Thank you.
along with hope goes the name of my sister Faith, who died 10 years ago, and I miss very much, and who has left a wonderful family who are very close.
This is for my mother, who was a heroine, and because during the war she had so many people believe that this too shall pass, and that was more than hope. She knew that this too shall pass. All we have to do is stay in the now, stay in the life, and that she passed, but she's so much with me that every day I'm with her. But this too shall pass is more than a hope. But hope had kept her alive through the Holocaust with me, and she said that because of me she is alive, and I said because of her she was alive. I am alive, so I thank her.
Thank you, Irina. Freedom. Isaiah is always there where builders build a new jail. He says, "Alas, my grim sons, the sword is still not a plow." If one image of God will be somewhere chained in a cell, the chain will shackle us all in heaven and on earth. Angels will know the weight of the chain. Winds will not be free to curse even their own fate. The sky will be an endless prison roof if one captive will still remain in a cell at the end of time nearby. May this be a world where each person can live a life of his or her own choosing, to live as they wish, a person unique and like no other. May this be a world where each can seek and find and speak without fear, and to find the deepest joys unafraid. May we respect each other, and in that respect, find what is closest to our hearts and most precious. May we make with our hands and hearts and minds a free people in a free land. Freedom.
In memory of my father, who, when we came here after we fled Austria, joined the American army to fight for freedom.
Thank you,
something in the memory of our founding fathers, Thomas Jefferson, George Washington, etc., who set up the United States of America and, you know, put their lives on the line, and etc., etc.
Thank you, Ken.
Okay.
I too am thinking of the founding fathers who created the wonderful Declaration of Independence and the Constitution, guaranteeing our freedoms, and we really have to practice them in order to keep them. I'm thinking that so many times today, freedom to speak and to write are so challenged, to speak one's mind and to express one's own opinion is sometimes very difficult. So I'm thinking that these rights are guaranteed. The Bill of Rights guarantees our rights to express whatever opinion we have. And that goodwill is really, I think, to remember, goodwill is the most powerful force of the universe. I think sometimes it's hard to remember that, but it's goodwill that pulls us through many, many a difficulty.
Thank you, Jenny.
Love. Because my love is a limitless love, the cold moon shadow penetrates my flesh. Because I feel the awareness of things, I sigh at seeing the glistening water. Is my life but a vanishing bubble? Or can it be my life is more than that? Indeed, though I may be unworthy, at least my grief is pure because of you. May everyone know the embrace of love, the hands of care, the touch of tenderness. May everyone find the love that gives the strength to meet life's hardships, the courage to endure life's pains, the heart to overcome discouragement. Love is limitless when we give it to others, when it pours from our hearts. We love one another with our eyes. We love one another with our hands. We love one another with the work that we do. When we have known this, when we have been touched in our deepest being, then we know that in spite of all trouble and despair, in the end, it is love that is stronger than death.
Now, this may seem strange, but my little dog, Buzzy, I think I'm going to cry because this was the unconditional love that I have had in my life. And I hope wherever he is, dog heaven or wherever he is, that he spreads that love wherever he is. He has certainly given me 15 years of a most wonderful experience and irreplaceable probably. And I thank him. Little white dog, about this big.
Thank you, Romina. Well, this time of year, I always remember my godparents. And I was very fortunate that my godparents were my maternal grandmother, Mary O'Keefe, and her son, my uncle, Father Thomas O'Keefe, a Catholic priest. And this was his favorite holiday. And my daughter took all of my father's slides and put them on the computer. And the one that we all delighted in the most, I think, was my uncle, Father Tom, in front of the Christmas tree, going like this to all of his nieces and nephews. He had all given us all tasks to do, and he was about to send us on our way to execute those tasks. This was his favorite time because all the family were together, and he died between Christmas and New Year's after having invited everyone together for a last supper with him. So they gave me the unconditional love that that everyone needs to survive.
to Mary and Tom. You're still loving us today. Lee Charlie. He was a boy I loved in high school. And he was killed by another driver who was running from the police. It was such a needless loss. And I know this is sort of non-ethical culture, but I have a friend in England who believes that she's in communication with the other side, wherever that is, and she has